Our first clinical site is at one of the most prestigious and probably the biggest cancer center, definitely in the United States and probably in the world.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Hemogenyx Pharmaceuticals CEO, Dr. Vladislav Sandler. Vladik, very good to see you. Happy New Year. You've announced the opening of your first trial site and patient recruitment for the clinical study of your lead drug. So a significant milestone for the company.
Hi, Stephen. It's good to see you in the new year. Happy New Year. Indeed, last year, we started our first clinical study of our CAR-T for the treatment of relapsed and refractory acute myeloid leukemia in adult patients. So the phase one trial is designed as a dose escalation study to evaluate the safety profile of our CAR-T. Our CAR-T is now known as HGCT1. This study is going to be conducted in adult patients with relapsed and refractory acute myeloid leukemia. The study has several secondary objectives in addition to the evaluation of the safety profile of this CAR-T. So these key secondary objectives include assessing the therapy's impact on the following clinical outcomes. First of all, its efficacy of our CAR-T based on AML-specific response criteria. Then overall survival of the treated patients, then progression-free survival in these patients, and duration of response. Obviously, the primary objective of this trial, as I mentioned, is to evaluate safety profile of our CAR-T. I have to emphasize that the opening of our first clinical site for phase one trial of our CAR-T is a true milestone for our company, and it's a true milestone in our mission to revolutionize the treatment landscape for relapsed and refractory acute myeloid leukemia. So this trial offers hope to patients who currently face limited treatment options by exploring the safety and potential efficacy of our CAR-T. We are very excited to start this trial.
And Vladik is being carried out at a top cancer research institution, is that right?
Yes, that's correct. Our first clinical site is at one of the most prestigious and probably the biggest cancer center, definitely in the United States and probably in the world.
So what should we be looking out for from here? So now that you have started the patient recruitment, what sort of milestones should your investors be watching out for next?
Well, obviously, the moment the first patient is identified, this patient is going to be tested for inclusion and exclusion criteria to figure out if this patient really fits the criteria to be included into this trial. The physicians at our clinical site will draw blood from this patient, isolate mononuclear cells or white blood cells from these patients, freeze them, send these cells to us, and in parallel to the site where these cells are going to be tested for certain markers to identify if these cells are good for manufacturing. And then we will obviously manufacture CAR-T cells using these isolated from the patient cells, test them and freeze them and send them back to the hospital for the injection. So the goal is to do first in human of our CAR-T. Then, according to the protocol of the clinical study, the patient is going to be followed for 28 days to identify if a given dose of CAR T injected into that patient is safe. And then this patient is going to be followed for hopefully many months and maybe even years to see what's the efficacy, what's the durability of the response, and so on and so on. After 28 days, if there are no dose-limiting toxicities, if there are no side effects, the physicians at our clinical site will move to recruit the second patient.
Vladik, do you have anything else to add about the trial and other trials that may spring out of this?
We opened phase one clinical trials for adult patients. However, we are already working on expanding these trials into pediatric patients. And these trials in pediatric patients will include relapsed and refractory acute myeloid leukemia in children, and also a subtype of acute lymphoblastic leukemia, which often happens in very young children or sometimes even in infants who are less than 2 years old. So that's the next step. And the third step, we are also planning to expand our trials of our CAR T HGCT1 into patients that suffer from a very rare blood disease, which is BPDCN. BPDCN stands for blastic plasmacytoid dendritic cell neoplasm. So these are our targets, and we will obviously update our investors and everyone who is interested on the progression of this expansion.
Vladik, thank you very much for your time today. It's Dr. Vladislav Sandler, CEO of Hemogenyx Pharmaceuticals.
Thank you.